7 Health Benefits of Manuka Honey, Based on Science. Manuka honey is a type of honey native to New Zealand. It's produced by bees who pollinate the flower Leptospermum scaparium, commonly known as the Manuka bush. Manuka honey's antibacterial properties are what set it apart from traditional honey.
Manuka honey's antibacterial properties are what set it apart from traditional honey.
Additionally, Manuka honey has antiviral, anti-inflammatory, and antioxidant benefits. In fact, it has traditionally been used for wound healing, soothing sore throats, preventing tooth decay, and improving digestive issues. Here are 7 science-based health benefits of Manuka honey. 1. Aid wound healing. Since ancient times, honey has been used to treat wounds, burns, sores, and boils. In 2007, Manuka honey was approved by the US FDA as an option for wound treatment. Honey offers antibacterial and antioxidant properties, all while maintaining a moist wound environment and protective barrier, which prevents microbial infections in the wound. Multiple studies have shown that Manuka honey can enhance wound healing, amplify the regeneration of tissue, and even decrease pain in patients suffering from burns. For example, one 2-week study investigated the effects of applying a Manuka honey dressing on 40 people with non-healing wounds. The results showed that 88% of the wounds decreased in size. Moreover, it helped create an acidic wound environment, which favors wound healing.
Multiple studies have shown that Manuka honey can enhance wound healing, amplify the regeneration of tissue, and even decrease pain in patients suffering from burns.
Additionally, a Greek study showed that Manuka honey wound dressings reduced healing time and disinfected wounds in patients with diabetic foot ulcers. Another study observed the effectiveness of Manuka honey in healing eyelid wounds after surgery. They found all eyelid wounds healed well, regardless of whether the incisions were treated with Manuka honey or Vaseline. However, patients reported that scarring treated with Manuka honey was less stiff and significantly less painful compared to scarring treated with Vaseline. Lastly, Manuka honey is effective at treating wound infections caused by antibiotic-resistant strains, such as Staphylococcus aureus, MRSA. Hence, the regular topical application of Manuka honey on wounds and infections may help prevent MRSA. 2. Promote oral health. According to the CDC, almost 50% of Americans have some form of periodontal disease. To avoid tooth decay and keep your gums healthy, it is important to minimize bad oral bacteria that can cause plaque formation. It's also important not to totally wipe out the good oral bacteria that is responsible for keeping your mouth healthy. Studies have shown Manuka honey attacks harmful oral bacteria associated with plaque formation, gum inflammation, and tooth decay. Specifically, research has shown that Manuka honey with a high antibacterial activity is effective at inhibiting the growth of harmful oral bacteria like P.
2. Promote oral health.
The honey chew was made of Manuka honey, and similar to a chewy honey candy. After their 3 daily meals, participants were instructed to either chew or suck on the honey chew for 10 minutes, or chew a sugar-free gum.
To avoid tooth decay and keep your gums healthy, it is important to minimize bad oral bacteria that can cause plaque formation.
The idea of consuming honey for good oral health may seem counterintuitive, as you have probably been told that consuming too many sweets can lead to cavities. However, unlike candy and refined sugar, Manuka honey's potent antibacterial effects make it more unlikely to contribute to cavities or tooth decay.
Specifically, research has shown that Manuka honey with a high antibacterial activity is effective at inhibiting the growth of harmful oral bacteria like P.
Its antiviral and antibacterial properties can reduce inflammation and attack the bacteria that cause pain. Not only does Manuka honey attack harmful bacteria, it also coats the inner lining of the throat for a soothing effect.
The honey chew was made of Manuka honey and similar to a chewy honey candy.
Interestingly, researchers found a significant decrease in Streptococcus mutans after they consumed Manuka honey. Moreover, Manuka honey decreases harmful oral bacteria that causes mucositis, a common side effect of radiation and chemotherapy. Mucositis results in inflammation and painful ulcerations of the mucous membranes lining the esophagus and digestive tract. For quite some time, various types of honey have been touted as natural cough suppressants. In fact, one study found honey was as effective as a common cough suppressant. Although Manuka honey wasn't used in this study, it's likely to be just as effective at suppressing coughs. 4. Help prevent gastric ulcers. Stomach ulcers are one of the most common illnesses affecting humans.
Its antiviral and antibacterial properties can reduce inflammation and attack the bacteria that cause pain. Not only does Manuka honey attack harmful bacteria, it also coats the inner lining of the throat for a soothing effect.
Research suggests that Manuka honey may help treat gastric ulcers caused by H. pylori. For example, a test tube study examined its effects on biopsies of gastric ulcers caused by H. pylori. The results were positive and implied that Manuka honey is a useful antibacterial agent against H. pylori. However, a small 2-week study in 12 individuals who took 1 tablespoon of Manuka honey by mouth daily showed that it did not decrease H. pylori bacteria. Thus, more research is needed to fully assess its ability to treat gastric ulcers caused by H.
In fact, one study found honey was as effective as a common cough suppressant. Although Manuka honey wasn't used in this study, it's likely to be just as effective at suppressing coughs. 4. Help prevent gastric ulcers. Stomach ulcers are one of the most common illnesses affecting humans. They are sores that form on the lining of the stomach, causing stomach pain, nausea and bloating. H. pylori is a common type of bacteria that is responsible for the majority of gastric ulcers. Research suggests that Manuka honey may help treat gastric ulcers caused by H. pylori. For example, a test tube study examined its effects on biopsies of gastric ulcers caused by H. pylori. The results were positive and implied that Manuka honey is a useful antibacterial agent against H. pylori. However, a small 2-week study in 12 individuals who took 1 tablespoon of Manuka honey by mouth daily shows that it did not decrease H. pylori bacteria. Thus, more research is needed to fully assess its ability to treat gastric ulcers caused by H. pylori. Gastric ulcers could also be caused by excessive alcohol consumption. Yet, a study in rats shows that Manuka honey helped prevent alcohol-induced gastric ulcers. 5. Improved digestive symptoms. Irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, is a common digestive disorder. Its associated symptoms include constipation, diarrhea, abdominal pain and irregular bowel movements. Interestingly, researchers have discovered that regularly consuming Manuka honey may help decrease these symptoms. Manuka honey has been proven to improve antioxidant status and reduce inflammation in rats with both IBS and ulcerative colitis, a type of irritable bowel disease. It has also been shown to attack strains of Clostridium difficile. Clostridium difficile, often called C. diff, is a type of bacterial infection that causes severe diarrhea and inflammation of the bowel. C. diff is commonly treated with antibiotics. However, a recent study observed the effectiveness of Manuka honey on C. diff strains. Manuka honey killed C. diff cells, making it a possibly effective treatment. It is important to note that the above studies observed Manuka honey's influence on bacterial infections in rat and test tube studies. Further research is needed to come to a full conclusion regarding its influence on bacterial infections of the bowel. 6. May treat symptoms of cystic fibrosis. Cystic fibrosis is an inherited disorder that damages the lungs and can also affect the digestive system and other organs. It affects the cells that produce mucus, causing mucus to be abnormally thick and sticky. This thick mucus clogs airways and ducts, making it difficult to breathe.